project really started with this idea of like, how do we increase algae's tolerance to hyperoxia? Because if you grow algae in a pond for biofuel production, often a lot of oxygen is produced because oxygen is a byproduct of photosynthesis. We were looking at these strains and trying to figure out why one was more tolerant to hyperoxia than the other. And I started thinking about the CCM, or the carbon concentrating mechanism, which is a mechanism in which algae concentrate carbon in their cells so that they can continue to do photosynthesis even under low CO2 conditions. The heart piece of the carbon concentrating mechanism is the structure called the pyrenoid, which is the starch sheath that forms around a matrix within the algae cell, and then CO2 is pumped into the cell and then into this matrix. It's well known that the pyrenoid exists. It's been known to exist for over 100 years. We didn't actually know what the signal for pyrenoid formation was. I thought, well, the CCM, the pyrenoid, that might have something to do with the reason an algae is tolerant to hyperoxia or not. We'd looked under a light microscope at these strains, and you could clearly see that the strains that were more tolerant to hyperoxia tended to have stronger, tighter pyrenoids. And so it was kind of crazy because for the past 30 or 40 years, everyone's been saying that the pyrenoid is induced by low CO2. But we found that actually you could have high CO2 and just throw in some oxygen and you'd get a spectacular pyrenoid. We found that high oxygen induced the pyrenoid. From this, we were able to surmise the CCM in general is not just induced by low CO2 conditions. From that, we were able to come up with some hypotheses for some alternative signals. In the paper, we proposed that hydrogen peroxide may be another signal for the induction of the CCM. And we see that if you pretreat algae with hydrogen peroxide, that the CCM can be induced. There is the idea is if you want to increase algae's tolerance to hyperoxia or certain strains that are sensitive, it does appear that simple pretreatment with hydrogen peroxide may actually help. Now that we know the signal to induce the CCM, we can more easily deduce the rest of the genes involved in pyrenoid formation, in the CCM formation, and from that it will give us the ability to turn those genes on in strains that might not have them turned on. Not only was this paper a collaborative experience between Dave and Josh and me and then the other co-authors, but I think it was also a collaborative experience with the CCM community and the algal research community as a whole.